Today, our training is not theoretical training, it's in-hand, on-hand training, which means all the material I'm going to use is the practical material, which we really have here, and also including the site visit to see the physical connections, physical devices. The first class we are going to do is, let me show you one list. This was the first weak subject. So except structured text and RS-485 Modbus, we have covered most of the subject here. And this second week, clear Scada. What we did not cover is the backup and the restore procedure for the database. And templated instances, that's a quite high-end, high level of graphical functionality, which we did not cover here. Originally, this program has been targeted for less people here. Not 16 people, it's 11 people. 8 from Takawasa and 3 from Hyundai Rotem. But unfortunately, we have more people here, so the overall progress slowed down. So we could not cover most of the many cases here. But I believe there are still that we have covered the basic functionalities of the clear Scada. So my intention is not to go further on clear Scada. If you have any questions, I can answer. But today class, I would like to include how to back up the database and how to restore the database.
That's important.
Right. You don't have this one? You don't have this one?
No, I
have
changed.
Oh, okay. And the third class was about the system architecture we have covered already. And on-site training, mostly on-site training, has been included in original original training schedule. So we go further on PLC function blocks for radio communications and the radio system hardware. This will be covered when you go down to the detail. And some case studies were included. And last week, original plan was PLC and MCC. We have covered part of the previous class. And the PLC and MOV, which will be covered today, case study in the analog signal instrument. We have certain instrument theories, two-wire, four-wire instruments. We have this two-wire, four-wire, both system in our plant. And flow meta processing, PLC SCADA scaling value for field instruments, and deep tube wear and the power failure, the effect of power failure on deep tube wear. But here, mostly here, some of them are covered already by Q&A session, during the Q&A session, and some of them you may interest. And I asked the previous session of the class, what do you need? This is the paper I received from Mr. Schwab that you guys want to cover in this class. Some of them I can, some of them I can't. Because some of them I see this is general issues for all you guys, but some of the item is very, very specific item. And even though you learn those things, spending quite a lot of hours, like 2 days, 3 days, some of the subjects we need, but it's almost no use. You will not face such a problem in the coming 1 year, 2 year, or yearly, not even yearly, maybe every 5 year, one time maybe. That kind of subject I'm not going to, I have no intention to spend our time on such a subject. We have a much more important subject here. Device and key motor, ATS, automatic transfer switch, VFD inverter, PFI power factor improvement, and wire delta connection, timer configuration, SCADA pack. Alright, I think most of the items we can cover. A little bit, especially the VFD and the PFI, you need a certain theories. So unless you understand some theories, it is difficult to understand how PFI functions and how VFD functions. And here we have electrical background. How many electrical background here? Maybe 8, 9, and half of you have electrical background, but others not electrical background. Especially VFD and PFI, I cannot explain. I cannot make you understand if you don't have electrical background. You have to know what is real power, what is reactive power, and what is apparent power, and power factor, how the power factor is calculated, and the meaning of the power factor, and how the power factor is increased by installing the capacitor bank. And that is a purely theoretical background we require. So I will see if we have enough time, maybe I can go through a short time, but I don't expect that you guys without electrical background can understand well. And the wire delta connection we have covered a little bit yesterday, and timer configuration SCADA pack, we will, when we go down to deep tube well, we will also cover this subject. And the number two, troubleshooting case study, MOV fault, and HV to LV, I don't know what they mean. I assume that the requirement here, you want to have the general view from high voltage down to low voltage. And three, method of modification. You are quite interested in modifying something in the system, which is strongly not recommended. Okay? Even though you know how to do it, even though that is very simple, I recommend not to touch the system. If something goes wrong, you have no ability to restore the system. Okay? Everything is not going as per the class here. So even very simple one, I recommend not to touch, not to modify the system. That's my strong recommendation. Okay? I have many experiences. I have trained. This is not my first training program here. I have trained many people, quite capable people. Quite capable people. He knows what to do. But he tried to do some modification, very simple modification. Very simple, just one variable, number change. Time setting from 10 seconds to 30 seconds, that's all. It's very simple. He know how to do. Yeah, I believe he know how to do. But during, while he was doing that one, I think he made a slight mistake, but he did not understand what kind of mistake he made. And he was completely panicked. And he tried to fix that, but complete shutdown. He unintentionally shut down the system.
Yeah.
He did not know what he did. And he was completely panicked. And I was in a country side, and he was near the Seoul. It was plus 350 kilometers away. He called me, phoned me, tried to explain to me. I couldn't understand what he's talking about. He could not explain properly because he did not know what he did. So what is the phenomenon here? You see the PLC LED status, what you have in your computer, he could not understand, and emergency call. So in the night, I had to drive 300 kilometers all the night, and right there, it was a very simple mistake. I could not believe that he made such a mistake. It was a very simple mistake, just a one-click mistake. So I am here, strongly recommend you not to touch any programs, okay? Except you read. Even reading it must be careful, because while you are, once you are connected to the control system, just clicking one thing will make a difference.
Yeah.
Unless you understand what you are doing, then you should not do that. This is very important. So here, number one, DTVL running hour, base time change. Like I was asked to set up from 6 a.m. to 6 a.m., okay, 12 a.m. to 12 a.m. now. 12 p.m., not a.m., 12 p.m., 12 a.m., the midnight to midnight. And if you want to change it, okay, 1 o'clock to 1 o'clock, my recommendation is ask me. That's it. That is not urgent matter. Ask me. But still you want to know, I will show where is the program offline, that's no problem at all. And I can demonstrate the online modification also possible, but I do not recommend you to do that yourself.
No, sir. 12 a.m. to 12 a.m. is yeah. safe, but the timing come after so many late, 12:30 exact time coming.
It's a PLC time and the PC time are mismatched. So either I can use PC time or PLC time. I think PLC time is slower. It's not very synchronized. Yeah, I will take a look at that. And number two, a flow summary to be added for FIT 4001, 4002. It's already added, I saw that. You already have it. You already have that.
Okay.
Yeah, you already have it. Number three, also I can show you the offline how this is made. Number three, how to make a backup and restore. You are talking about the PLC software backup and restore, right? Here, we have 16 people here, okay? You don't need to understand everybody how to backup and restore. Just you need one person in charge, another person, next charge, or third, two, three people, okay, that's it. And if you try, backup, restore, no, this is not something, okay? So, of course, we will cover this one here, basics, and later on, if you give me the specified people who needs to, who are responsible for managing the database, then I can teach them separately, okay. Including the practice. About the PLC program and Scada database, Scada database is keep changing because every day it is recording the historical data. So the database is increasing. If you lose the server, you will lose the historical data too. So it is also advisable, it is recommended that you backup whole database, clear Scada database on weekly basis. So that in worst case, you lose everything, but you keep all historical data, just you lose a few days data, okay? regarding the PLC, you don't have to backup every week, because once the program is installed there, then rarely it is changing. So whenever change is made, modification is made, I will provide the responsible person, I will provide the update the PLC program. And restore, I cannot demonstrate restore because I have to shut down the system. So you want to know if something goes wrong, system failed, shut down, and you want to restore the system, right? So I cannot do that unless you allow the system shutdown for half an hour, I can demonstrate. Okay? And number four, how to upload and download PLC configure. I told you already, and the Scada pack, you have no reasons to touch it. So if something goes wrong with the Scada pack, you have to depend on it for the time being. The Scada pack is a very special device, and I did not show we use a very special software also. To be familiar with that software, also you need a minimum 3-5 days training again.
Which?
Okay. Number five, how to make a radio to bridge mode, health of communication and preventive maintenance. Okay. You will not face on monthly basis or yearly basis, you change a certain radio to bridge mode. This radio basis will be covered this week, and you will understand what is access point, what is bridge, what is remote, and how the communication is configured here and made. But that configuration also, I'm not recommending you touch that. Okay, I will show you here what is the bridge mode, how this is configured, but also it's my recommendation not to touch that. So, you have one question. If Mr. Zhang is not here, what should we do? Right? Okay. Number one, you have to contact the Schneider office to get the technical service. They will arrange the supervisor from Australia or Canada, whatever. Okay, this plant cannot be dependent on me. If I'm another variable, if I cannot come here long time, then you have to call, you have to call for the service from Schneider Electric. They will provide electrical services. It will take time, it's less effective, efficient, of course, because the engineer whoever comes here cannot cover clear Scada, PLC, radio, everything one time, no. Maybe two, three engineers will come here, one engineer cover radio, one engineer cover Scada pad, one engineer cover PLC, one engineer cover clear Scada, or whatever it is. But anyway, you can get the service. So in emergency case, you can get the service. And because such cases are not taking place every day or every month, it is advisable that if you have certain services required, and if I'm not available for the service from Schneider Electric, you have office here. You have office here in Dhaka. Okay, and number four, field visitor. Deep tube well, LV panel, 50 panel, RTU panel, generator, transformer. Definitely, obviously, we will cover this one. I will show you each device and how those devices are interconnected, how those devices are functioning, and what's the role in the DTBL. And number two, substation. This is your Dakawasa substation.
Yeah.
Ask me to visit over there and explain the substation equipment. I can do that, but I have never visited here IRP1 substation here. IRP2, two or three times I visited there, but IRP1 never visited, but it does not matter. Just I can go together with you, and from transformer and to you have a VCB, you have VCB. Have you ever heard of VCB and ACB?
ACB.
Okay. Are you electrical?
Yes.
Okay. What's the difference? VCB,
ACB. ACB and VCB.
Yeah.
ACB using too much high voltage.
Okay. And
ACB less.
Why? Why we cannot use ACB on high voltage? Why we cannot use VCB on low voltage?
I don't know.
Okay.
I think ARM vacuum.
I'm sorry?
Basically, ARM kick vacuum.
That's right. Vacuum and air.
Yeah.
Air circuit breaker and vacuum circuit breaker.
Yeah.
And we have TCB. We don't have TCB, I think. We have gas circuit breaker. SF6 gas.
SF6.
SF6 gas is used.
Sulfur explorer.
Do you know the functions? Why it's different? Why we cannot use that in low voltage and high voltage? Is it separating?
I don't know. I asked someone. He gave me some knowledge, but there is difference. The different difference, I think, the higher voltage and lower voltage is same. Because the platform and basically thing there.
Yeah.
Because higher voltage is, there is resistivity, I know, conductivity. So
you don't have to go there. You don't have to go there. Okay? When you open, close, always
spark.
One thing,
spark.
Fire is there. So this spark, you cannot just leave it.
Yeah.
You have to extinguish
immediately.
So, especially low voltage and the high voltage more spark.
More
dangerous. So you have 11 kilovolt here, VCB is 5, but if you go to 132 kilovolt or 400 kilovolt, VCB is not enough to extinguish the spark. ACB is low voltage, the spark is small, so just air, using just air is
fine.
Live in the air, no problem. But VCB is this contact point, we call it chamber, contact chamber is a vacuum
sealer.
There is no air, no oxygen there. So even though there is a spark there, it can be extinguished immediately because there is no oxygen on there. But still, SF6 gas is much, much better than vacuum in terms of extinguishing the fire.
Yeah.
So higher voltage, SF6 gas. And the difference is price, money. ACB is cheap, VCB is expensive. And the CCB is very expensive. One piece, more than 1 crore. Okay, so do you want to use CCB here in OGR? 400 volt? You can use, of course, no problem. If you are rich enough, no problem. I want to have a very stable system in our electrical loop. Fine, you install CCB, no problem at all. VCB, you can use VCB, no problem at all. But because of money, it's not necessary. cost is not justified. That's why we do not use a low voltage VCB or TCB. High voltage, we are forced. We have to use ACB. If you use ACB, you will have to fight there. Okay, that's yeah. And so substation, we will come down there and we take a look at VCB and ACB from appearance. From outside, you will not see any difference. Just inside, it's a hidden place, an invisible place. It's a vacuum, vacuum space. And also ask to visit the OGR electrical room and explain the facilities over there. Again, the electrical facilities are not supplied by me here. It was not designed by me at all. And the total commissioning was not my responsibility. So just I was asked to check, because I have certain electrical background, I was asked to check whenever there is a problem. That's it. So I do not have a complete understanding of those electrical facilities. I have drawing, but I did not study drawing. I studied the drawing whenever it is necessary. So when something is not working, then I trace from the drawing back, but I did not. I did not study this electrical system. This electrical system, it's designed well or not? I believe it's designed well. I don't know. I have never seen short circuit study document, and I have never seen other design document. Actually, what I have is panel drawing on there. So maybe I cannot give you the enough explanation, but I can give you basic explanation. I believe that there are no electrical person who is more knowledgeable than I. So I'm a little relaxed. Okay, we will do that. So today. Can I lift this one? Today, just with a light mind, even though you don't understand, no problem. Okay? Let's go through power first, power, electric power. Just I will spend 10 or 20 minutes to explain the power. Power. What is power? What's the power?
Energy.
Multiply of voltage and current.
Yeah, and in physical, his answer is very close to very generally. Power is energy. Okay. Power is
energy.
No, power is power.
Power is power.
Power is power. Like, if you are powerful, you can do more, right? Yeah. So there is big motor here. If you have less power, you cannot rotate it. You need a big power, right? And the power is calculated how?
Voltage and current.
That's right. Voltage and current.
With power factor.
Do we use there are two types of electricity here in the world. DC and AC,
yes.
Right?
Yeah.
And DC is a direct current, right?
Yeah.
AC is alternating current. This is a direct current. I don't know why it's not DV, it's direct voltage, but DC, they say DC. And this is a alternating
current.
Now, what's the difference?
Phase angle. Between voltage and current, they have no angle.
If we start talking about phase angle, it's too complicated. Yeah, many people cannot understand.
Alternating current changes for the position every time.
Okay, great, right. DC, do you know Edison?
Thomas Edison.
He was a sporting DC. Mm. Do you know Thomas Edison? He made which company?
General Electric.
Yeah. GE, General Electric. Very famous. General Electric. And AC. Who was supporting AC?
Tesla.
Tesla also passed right. And have you ever heard of Westinghouse?
Westinghouse. Yeah.
Westinghouse. General Electric and Westinghouse, these two companies are the biggest companies in the world producing
electric
car equipment, especially generator, turbines, gas turbines, steam turbines, and this kind of thing, all the electric. Westinghouse. And DC Edison, AC Westinghouse. Power, you said power, we call it P power, is defined, this is power, really power, is defined by mathematically voltage and current. Okay? If you have more voltage, you have more power. If you have more current, you have more power. Okay? So, you want to have the same power, but if voltage is increased, current will decrease.
Yes.
Right? You want to have the same power. 400 volt, you have one motor. It's an OGR pump motor. You want to run it. 400 volt, if you apply 400 volt, maybe you need 400 ampere, right? Yeah, 400 ampere, 420 ampere, something like that. But instead of 400 volt, 4000 volt, 4 kilo, kilovolt, 4000 volt, then the current will reduce 40 ampere. Really, it's really 40 ampere. Okay? If you apply 40 kilovolt, 4 ampere, the same power, because the power is just two, V and I and P. it's simple. For DC, finished. P and V and I. What is the power unit?
Ohm resistance.
Usually kilo, right? Watt. Kilo is 1000.
Yes.
What is the power unit? For DC, finished. Now AC is not finished. AC we have some problem. If P, this is DC, AC. AC is also
VI.
Okay? VI. It's okay. It's okay.
No, no.
But if V, you know AC, DC, voltage is this is time constant. This is DC. AC not constant.
Yeah.
This is time and voltage. If you look at voltage,
sine
wave. How many times? 1 second.
50 times.
50 hertz. Yeah. This will change. This is 50 times. Okay. This is a. You cannot see, but this is a AC. Now. If the current maybe the size, the value could be different, right? Cannot be same, but somehow it's moving together, up and down together, then this is correct.
Yes.
Same as AC. This is correct.
Yes.
But the problem is, the current in real world is not the same. Could be. Okay? Let's see now. At this point, how much is the power? This point. This point, how much is the power? At this point, power, what is V multiplied by I?
Zero, power zero.
Zero, because V is V equals zero, right?
Mm.
Here?
Zero.
Here?
Zero.
Right?
Yeah.
It was previously, it was zero here only, right? So it is quite apparent that if the current and the voltage are not moving together, same way, power will be different. Power is not the same, different. Okay? So, because of that problem, we cannot express in AC, we are using AC, AC, just if we multiply I, is not representing the power. Could be power, could be less power, could be zero, in worst case. Zero. So that's why we need to define different power definitions.
Yeah.
In AC, okay? Okay? You understand? Okay?
Yeah. Yes.
Understand? Okay?
Yeah.
So here, now, DC, this is kilowatt.
Yeah.
Finish. Simple. But AC, this is not kilowatt. AC, it's more complicated. There are three terms used in power. One is apparent power. This is just, it looks like that. So same as DC, we multiply by, we call it apparent power.
Yeah.
The unit is?
VA.
VA. Because voltage? Ampere. Okay. And the real power is real power. This is real power. This is really used to rotate the motor to work. Okay? So you see here, Mr. Azadi is here, right? He's very big man, right? So from outside, we see that he's very big man, maybe very powerful, right?
Yes.
And he tried to keep some money, but power is not so much big as his body size. That is real power. Real power, we call it P.
V I cos theta.
What is this? Just forget. Just forget it. Okay. This is what?
Kilowatt.
This is a watt. Okay. And now reactive power. Reactive power means, you see, his body is big, right? But his power is not so big. Then inside his body, there is some force. False space, right?
Yeah.
He's unnecessarily big.
Yeah.
Maybe his power is the same as a rule. So this size is enough, but he's taking too much space, right?
Yeah.
So this is the problem. Okay? Reactive power is a false power. It is existing in the circuit, but it's not used.
Not used, yeah.
I will change this one. Usually it is expressed as Q.
Sin theta.
What is sin theta? You don't have to know, okay?
Bar.
Okay. There are three powers now. Okay? Apparent power, his body space.
Yeah.
Real power, out of his space. You know Hassan, my driver?
Yes. Yeah.
My friend Hassan, he's big, but he's very weak. His real power is small. His apparent power is big. His real power is small. Reactive power is big. You understand? This cosine theta, what is the maximum value of cosine theta?
One.
Cosine, maximum value?
One.
And minimum value?
Zero.
Zero. Right? Cannot be more than one. So, cosine theta is always?
Zero to one.
One. And cosine theta is called power factor.
Power.
Now this is power factor. So power factor means, you know here, this is this one, right? So cosine theta, we call it power factor, equal,
yeah.
Correct?
Yeah.
Correct?
Yeah.
This is power factor, so, again, apparent power is body big. His body is 100, okay, space is 100, but his power is only 60 only. That power factor is 0.6.
0.6.
Okay, which means he is unnecessarily big. We can reduce his size. You understand?
But not how.
You understand?
Yeah.
This is power factor. Power factor is, now, he's here, and he cannot make the power more than his body, of course, he cannot. But if he can use all his body for the power, then power factor is one.
Yeah.
Everything becomes power, okay? This is the power factor. Now, yes, please.
That is the power factor we call the, the extra money provide the...
That's right, that's what I'm going to explain now. Now, I will explain. You have a power factor penalty, right?
Yeah.
Why do you have, why the electricity company is imposing penalty for you? You have a poor profit. Why is that so? Why is that so? You see, if you look at your electricity bill, you are paid, you have to pay based on what? Because this is a real power, right? So if you do not use electrically reactive power, the space is there, but you are not using. You don't use, why you pay? So you use, then you pay. You don't use, you don't pay, right? But electricity company has different view. Now, Mr. Azad, his power factor is 0.5 only. Okay? But because of poor power factor, electricity company, he provides double capacity. Transformer, cable, maybe cable, we can, he can make a thin, right?
Yeah.
Transformer, smaller size, he can make electricity company. But because of his body is too big, the electricity company should prepare bigger transformer, bigger cable, bigger facilities. So don't lie. Electricity company, they think if he can reduce his body size, because his body size can be reduced to 0.5, then they can use the extra capacity to other people, right?
Yeah.
Overall, countrywide, nationwide, if the power factor is improved, which means he can reduce his size, the unnecessary power, and we, they reserve unused, unnecessary power, and they can use it for better use. So from electricity company point of view, he has to invest more money for the consumer if the consumer has poor power factor. What he really needs is only 50 kilowatt, but he needs more capacity because of his poor power factor. More current, more voltage. He needs more current, more voltage. Okay, so electricity company should prepare bigger transformer, bigger breakers, and bigger electrical equipment because his power package is poor. That's why penalty is here. Okay?
Yeah.
Understand? If you do not understand, you don't have to be frustrated. Because this is quite a...
What is the practice in South Korea?
How many?
What is the practice in South Korea?
0.95.
0.95.
0.95? Yes. 0.95 and... we have, you have here in this country, I know the electricity system here.
Is there any penalty applicable in South Korea also?
Yes, of course.
Be careful.
First, you see here, we have two penalties. We have two penalties. One is power factor penalty. It's 0.95, same as Bangladesh. 0.95. So they allow 5% extra. Okay, fine. You can take 5% extra. You use 100 kilowatt, right? But your capacity is 105. Fine, no penalty. But if more than 105, then you should pay. You should pay penalty. And two, peak demand. Demand demand. That's right.
What is it?
Yeah, I mean explain. You have this kind of concept, not exactly the same as Korea, but if you look at your electric charge, then there is off, peak,
on
peak.
Yeah.
Peak, off peak. From 5 o'clock in the afternoon to 11 o'clock evening, it's peak time. If you use more electricity, same electricity, but it's more money. Peak. These two are related to your electricity bill. Power factor, understand now, okay? And peak demand means when you make the electricity supply from DESCO or NESCO or DPDC, REB, whatever, then you have to submit that I need the power capacity here, 10 kVA. We call it kVA and kilowatt, let's say kilowatt. For most of people, kilowatt is more convenient. So I am going to use maximum 10 kilowatt, okay? We call it, this is a contracted capacity. Okay, contracted capacity. So, we say 100 kilowatt is our maximum capacity. So give us the 100 capacity. Then If you give more, 20 kilowatt, then of course you have to pay more. This is not about how much you use. This is about the maximum capacity. This is the basic charge. Whether you use or not, this is charge. There is charge based on your constructive capacity. So the problem is, if you use more than contracted capacity, what's going to happen? What's going to happen? Here, this is kilowatt. This is a time. This is 1 year time. 1 year. Okay, your contracted capacity is 10 kilowatt. Right? Most of the time, you are using less than that, okay? But only 1 minute. Only 1 minute, this is a 1 minute.
Like motor current.
30 kilowatt use, okay? Then what your electricity company is going to do? It's a problem because the electricity, every electricity is looking at the maximum. Looking at the maximum power. The electric company is not looking at prepared for average power.
Yeah.
All facilities, generation capacity, transformers, cables are prepared for maximum peak, on the peak demand, okay? So you have to keep this one. Otherwise, if it's sparked up, which means electricity company is uncomfortable. Maybe they have to prepare bigger capacity of a transformer and a bigger generation power generation plant. Because if this is happening too many places, you will have blackout. Power generator is overloaded instantly. And if generator power generator is overloaded, it will trip.
But transformer.
Not transformer. Generator.
Oh.
Power generator. Power generation plant.
Yeah.
Power generator can produce certain amount. If he is asked to produce more, he is overloaded. And it is tripped. If it tripped, then you have short power. You need more power, but one generator trip, you lost 200 megawatt, for example.
Yeah.
It's a big problem. Then which means this 200 megawatt will be imposed to other generators. Other generator will be overloaded, trip one by one, and the nationwide blackout. It's quite serious. So this is quite serious situation. In this case, your electricity company maybe forgive you one time, two times, but it is repeated. They will ask you to increase your contracting power, and at the same time, they will penalty the peak demand. Okay, this is two concepts. It's all about the capacity. About the capacity.
Okay.
So that's why, you know, from 5 o'clock to 11 o'clock, your country, is most of people, they go back to house, turn on the light, turn on the AC, turn on the heater, turn on the television, turn on your computers and things like that. So more power is required. So that's why they want to, because the electricity companies and here, PDB or other authorities, they want to suppress your electricity use in that time period. Everybody is using more electricity, which means the generator is difficult.
Okay.
That's why they ask you to pay more money if you use in that period.
Okay?
Okay.
Okay.
So power factor improvement is okay. Then this power factor is decided by what? What is changing the power factor?
Power factor?
Power factor is determined, decided by what?
The phase angle. Current and voltage.
For the phase angle, yeah. Here I'm not talking about phase angle here. It's too complex, okay?
Load.
Your load.
Maybe the electric load?
Your load.
Capacity.
Your load. If you use heater like this, this power factor is almost 1.
Yeah.
This is nature of the load. The motor you use, right? Induction motor, the three-phase motor is at average power factor 0.5 to 0.585.
Yeah.
0.8 to 0.85. So if you load here, you are using mostly the motor, then you will get 0.8 8 or 8.5 pulse. And fluorescent lighting here. This one also it's a pet, it has a poor power factor. And you have AC, right? AC, yeah. Most of the load is compressor. Compressor also you have power factor 0.8. So in nature, naturally, in here, in plant, in this plant, the major power consumption by motor, pump, right? So your power factor is in nature, if you do not control it, your power factor will end up with power factor 0.585 or 0.83 something. Then you will face penalty. The penalty is quite heavy. 0.01, so 1% less than 1% more now. You have to pay 1% more. 0.85 means you have to pay 10% more. Okay, so that's why you need power factor improvement. And if you look at, you did not notice maybe the previous day, but if you look at the MCC circuit diagram, you will find capacitor.
Yes.
Are we sure?
Big size.
This is capacitor. Okay? Mm-hmm. So, you see here, this is connected directly to the motor, right?
Yeah.
So, if breaker is off, this capacitor off.
Mm.
If this is not running, this is closed and running, right? If this is not running, also capacitor off. But as soon as this is closed, the voltage is right here, voltage is coming here too.
Mm.
So, it is working only when the motor is running. Of course, it should be. If motor is not running, if you turn on the capacitor, then you have another problem. So of course, power factor is poor, and you have a minus power factor, and you will have the voltage rise. Voltage is abnormally high, become high, and you will have a very strange phenomenon if the capacitor is kept on. So here you see the capacitor, and In this system, in electrical system here, from the viewpoint of a power factor control, it's fine. It's well.
So Mr. Jang, so we use this capacitor for increase our power factor.
That's right. That is the purpose of the power factor.
Actually, how can the capacitor increase the power factor?
Really, you want to know?
Yeah.
I have to go a little bit more. Okay. In electricity, there is always couple, voltage to current, right? There are couples, and inductor to capacitor. Inductor means, what do you know what is inductor? Coil.
Coil, yes.
Copper coil is inductor.
Yeah, the one who passes the current.
Yeah, coil. So motor, also it's coil. Inside coil. So motor itself is an inductor, actually. Inductor. And the opposite term of inductor is capacitor.
Condenser.
Do you know what is the capacitor?
Yes.
Condenser.
Yeah.
Condenser. What is condenser? We know the inductor is coil. Then what about capacitor?
Capacitor is stored the charge. Stored the charge for a certain time.
What is it made? What's the component of the capacitor? Inductor is a coil, copper coil. Capacitor?
Capacitor to coil and it has an insulation.
So, what is the material of capacitor? That's what I'm asking.
It's two plates. Dielectric material, paper.
It's paper or ceramic.
Ceramic,
okay.
Yes.
This is the main component of the capacitor. So it is compressed the shape of the paper.
Yeah.
Compressed the shape of the paper. It's the basic insulation material. We call it, it is not ceramic, it is called cellular.
Cellular.
Dielectric material.
Dielectric material. And now, inductor, I told you, motor is bring down what? The power factor.
Yeah.
And the capacitor itself is increasing the power. If you have a capacitor in your circuit, power factor is increased.
Yeah, more capacitor, more power.
That's right, but not 100% true. Okay. So in real world here, the load, we have many loads, right? Load itself has no capacitance. Mostly this is an inductor, coil is dominant. Of course, there are some capacitor components, but it's smaller. It's the most major part is
inductor.
Right. So you need to understand here, I will use a little bit mathematics, okay? This is a apparent power. His size, body size.
Yeah.
And this is the power he can really produce. And this is a reactive power. Reactive power. This is the Bayes equation. Pythagoras.
Yes.
Mm-hmm. Pythagoras. Okay, so if you
as
here, this is P, we call it this is Q, okay?
Yes.
So if P is this much, okay, Q is this much, then this is S, okay?
Yeah.
Because it's Pythagoras, this is Q, this is P.
P.
Alright?
Yes.
Now, here, inductor, coil, inductor is coming this way.
Mm-hmm.
So more inductor,
more
S, right? P will be reduced. You understand?
Yes,
P is
yes.
reduced. Alright? Okay? Yes. Capacitor, this way. It's opposite.
Yeah.
So, now you have this much here, inductive load. So power factor is, this is theta, this is power factor.
Yeah.
So if zero, then power factor one. So if there is no Q, then P equals S, S equals P. His size and his power is the same.
Mm.
If this is 90 degree, there is no power. He has big body, but he has no power. Okay, worst case. So capacitor, if you install the capacitor exactly this much size here, then this becomes S.
Okay.
Equal.
Equal. And the theta, zero. Cosine theta, one. So if you know this Q value in your system, then you can calculate minus Q, this is the capacitor. And you install that size of capacitor, then you will get power factor 1. This is the theory. Okay, now this one we will go through a little bit more next time when we come to PFI. The PFI is a capacitor. We call it capacitor or condenser. Band. Condenser capacitor. Band.
Yeah.
What's the difference between condenser and capacitor? Anybody knows the difference between condenser and capacitor?
Maybe condenser hold the electricity more time than the capacitor.
Do you know Xerox?
Xerox, yes.
Xerox, what is Xerox?
Photocopier machine.
Yes. If I say, please make a copy of this with Xerox, then you understand, right? Even though that is not Xerox, it's a HP. You understand, right? Condenser is like Xerox. And capacitor is academic word. Academic word. The condenser and the capacitor are same actually. The first product, the most widely used in the world of the capacitor was called condenser. That's why now we are saying condenser. Like we copy machine, we say Xerox. Same thing. Okay. Now let's come back to the real class today. What I'm going to do now is MOV 2V05A. We created a clear Scada. We also reviewed the PLC logic, and we learned how clear Scada and PLC are communicating using the Modbus address and the PLC address. They are linked. And now I will show you the MOV circuit drawing here, and we will trace from Scada all the way to MOV. Complete circuit, we will see, I will show you complete circuit. It is the same, if you understand this MOV, it's same for all the equipment, the pump, and whatever it is. It's the same principle. So, first of all, anyway, okay. Actually, the drawing is like this. I took from your MOV, and I'm not going to return this to hard. So you can find any MOV you have drawing. And the important thing is here. Here is a switch unit assembly, integral unit assembly, and here also in left side, operating unit assembly, some motor circuit was showing, but the scan was not properly done here. Anyway. Here, the important thing is terminal unit assembly. There is a number, right? From 1 to 34. How this is made inside circuit, that's not our interest. And here you see remote control, remote monitor, running for full open, full close, open torque, close torque. Okay? And here also output DC, 4 to 20 million, some analog signals here. This one is just the information. This is just the key part I want to. So, remote control, for example, okay. 11 is common. Okay, 11 is common. And the remote open is 2, right? This is the remote open command. So, 2 and 11. The wire, this two, is short out, shorted, jumpered here, then it will open. The inside somehow the circuit is working. Okay, again.
Mr. Jang, here's the number for the notation 1, 2, 3, 4. This is the terminal number.
That's terminal number. You will see that. I took photo. Just a moment. I will show you the photo. Better. I show you the photo.
Take two.
There is it. and the common, 11. So this means here, if these two is shorted out, it's connected from outside, then remote open command is working. Okay? So from here, the cable is flying to the PLC. If the PLC gives the command, here the contact switch is closed. So these two, through the PLC, it's connected this way.
So 1 and 11.
2 and 11. That's right. Okay, so
FCP. Who is common? How we can understand?
Come again?
2 is common.
Uh-huh.
How can we understand there is a 2 common?
2 common?
Yeah.
Which one? How again?
2 to 2. 11 is common.
11.
Telikas.
Actually,
common.
Here 1 is common. Sorry, 1 is common here. This is 24 volt is here. And this is 224 volt. It shorted out, then it goes to OP.
Okay, so okay. If we want to remotely close, so we
1 and 2.
1 and 3.
Three. 1 and 2 close. If these two is closed here, okay, then open.
Open, yes, then open. And 1 and 3 means
here,
close.
Closed, then it's
close.
Closing. Close command. And the next is a stop command.
So this is the manufacturer.
Manufacturer drawing. This is a manufacturer drawing. Usually the manual is coming together, which has a certain explanation. But if you cannot find such instruction, then from drawing you should understand. It's not your job to understand this one, because this is an engineering company. The Hyundai Rotem should provide this kind of information, and then the field installation company install it. If there is a modification, they will inform the HRC. HRC should revise the drawing and submit it to it. Now here, again, this is 1 and 2, right?
Yes.
And 1, 3. And the remote stop, usually we don't use. Only 2-base-07 used. Nothing, not used. Yeah, emergency stop, not used. Auto, not used. And here next, remote monitor, right? So monitor common is 7, remote 8. If the MOV is in remote position, then this one inside here, it's closed. And this is going to the PLC. Okay, this side, we keep the command the switch here, right? But this side, the MOV will give you the closed contact here. And then you will receive closed contact if the MOV is in remote position. If MOV is a local position, you can receive 9. This is not used. We are not receiving that. We receive only remote. So if remote is not coming, we think this is local. And the running, opening here. Opening, closing, port, right? Here, what we use in our system, we do not use all the signal. We use remote signal. We receive remote. We are not receiving local. We receive remote. And running, opening, closing, we are not receiving. We are not receiving. In Scada we have, right? That is made by logic. That is made by logic, not from here. But we can receive. We can receive, it's possible, but we are not receiving. And we have fault, right? Fault NO and CNO means normally open, and CNO means normally closed. Normally open means if fault is coming, then close. Normally open. So we use normal fault, normal open. We receive this one. And now full open, full close, what is this?
Limit switch.
Limit switch. Open, close, limit switch. So you can use limit switch, NO, normal open, normal contact, whatever it is. We receive normal open contact. Okay, our system is connected here, 2021. 28, 29. And then next is a torque switch. Open torque, close torque. What is torque switch?
Torque switch actually check the position of the valve.
This is related to the motor protection.
Yes.
First, the limit switch. I think this MOV also has the function, the limit switch will cut the motor power.
Yeah.
Okay? Motor power. Also, PLC is cutting the out, canceling the out. But somehow, the limit switch, anybody adjusted the limit switch?
No, Mr. Alambi.
I see.
Alambi, you adjusted the limit switch?
Yeah, I see.
Limit switch. Okay? So, limit switch is adjusted. Okay?
Mm-hmm.
If this is not properly adjusted, or it is deviated from the adjusted position somehow, it's not working. It cannot cut the motor power. Motor power will
over pressure.
Then motor will try to rotate further. Mechanically, it can.
Okay.
Which means motor will be overloaded.
Yeah.
Somehow, motor should be stopped. Otherwise, you will end up with burn more.
Yeah.
Right? So, the next protection is a torque switch.
Yeah.
So limit switch, torque switch. Torque switch is after limit switch, mm-hmm. not before limit switch,
mm-hmm.
always. Okay? So torque switch is a second protection to stop the motor. If a limit switch fails, torque switch, you have to use torque switch. And then this torque switch also adjusted. It is adjusted. And then if limit switch, torque switch, both are not working somehow, then electrical protection next comes, overload protection. If the current is too much, or the temperature is too high, there is some detection circuit, it will cut off the power.
Mm.
So there, this torque switch is related to the protection.
The three-layer protection.
So torque switch, PLC is not issue. Don't need. Just we issue full close, full open, normally open contact. So it is correct 2021, 2029. Remote monitor, remote A, we are receiving. And remote control, we are doing the remote control. So open command, close command. These are all we receive and connected to the system. And which is have you ever seen this drawing?
Yes.
What is the title? Cable connection list. This is a construction drawing. It is construction drawing. So, the people who are working at the field, okay, system engineer limited. The people, they don't know the PLC. They don't know the MOV. But they have to lay the cable, they have to connect it. So somebody give them the connection information. So this is plug. What is this one? Filter, MOV, right?
Yeah.
MOV. From MOV. This is number. MOV number. From this one to use this type cable, 10 core, 1.5 square mm cable size, right?
Yeah.
And here two, where? FCP.
Yeah.
FCP, terminal number, 1 to 1, 29 to Z135, this is a cable number. 21 to Z134. 17 to 32. Z132. Just connected. So they don't know what it is, okay? The field people who are working at the site, laying the cable, connecting the technicians, they don't know what it is.
Yeah.
But all information here, what they need to know. They don't have to understand what this means. But they look at, okay, 17 to
32.
Z132.
17
means?
Z132.
17 means?
17 is false.
17 means?
Fault. Fault.
Fault.
No.
Okay?
Yes.
Because they open, they look at the 17. They can find 17. From here, they lay the cable to
Z136.
Where?
32.
Z132. This is FCP 201, right? So I have drawing FCP, drawing here. This is FCP 201. Right?
Yeah.
201. What's the number?
32.
32?
32.
Z1, here Z1, right?
Z1. Here.
It was 32 here, right?
Yes.
So this is field, 2.05. 32. It is connected to the 32. So what is the number here? 17. This number is 17 here. This is MOV, right? This number 17, this is 32. That one, 32. And this portion is field cable. Okay? So you receive this drawing, you receive MOV drawing, and you have to make, if you are designer, of course, you have to make, you have to create the drawing like this. You give the drawing. This is a connection. This is connection detail. 17, MOV side, is connected to FCP 201Z132. Okay? Alright?
Yes.
And let's see the open command here. This is open command, right? There's a common line open command because two wires should go there. Not one wire, two wire. So here, open command is given, then it is coming Z1 38 to 7. And the common line 37 to 6. Right?
Yes.
Okay. So Z1 38. This is open command. I have a little doubt here about this. Command. This is command. Lamp. This is lamp. Okay, here. 206, 205, see here, Z1 37, 38, Z1 37, 38, this is coming to, going to one contact, K01 contact, it's going to K01 is here, and this one is coming from PLC DDI, DDO, output channel number 3, K01 going to Z1 37, 38, correct?
Yes.
Z1 37 38 is 37 38. Now field cable going to field cable and the MOV 1 and 2. 1 and 2. So MOV it is connected to cable 1 and 2 remote open. So let's look at here. This is the MOV side. Again, from the very beginning to the end, let's see how it goes. Maybe, shall we take a break?
Yes.
Yeah, shall we take a break and I will show you the full path. Mm-hmm. Let's take a break.
Mm-hmm.